I'm joined on console now by Mike Ewert, who is the co-inventor of a pretty, you know, fascinating device that's come out of a lot of space research, a solar-powered refrigerator. Now, Mike, why don't you tell us a little bit about the work and kind of what it is? I mean, it's obviously it's a refrigerator, it can keep things cool for extended periods of time. What's so special about this one?
Okay, Dan. Yeah, it's actually technology development work that began quite a few years ago. Obviously, we need refrigeration in space as well as down here on Earth. And we were actually looking at cooling lunar bases originally and looking at the power that was available on the moon. And solar power is abundant. And during the day, when we need the most cooling, is when the sun was most available. So I started looking at the synergy between the solar photovoltaic power source and the power need for the compressor. That eventually led to looking at applications on Earth, because obviously we need new renewable energy sources on Earth. And we started working on refrigerators that were directly powered by the sun. So it's a traditional compressor type refrigerator. But the unique thing is that the photovoltaic or solar panel is tied directly to the compressor and runs in proportion to the amount of sunshine available. So we call it a battery-free solar refrigerator.
So battery-free. It doesn't have a battery. It's not, you know, plugged into a power grid or anything like that. This is directly just 100% solar-powered.
Correct. And so one thing that was required to make that work is to have some kind of energy storage. Traditionally, out in areas where you don't have electricity, where you might have a solar-powered refrigerator, you'd have a large bank of batteries that would store electrical energy to run the refrigerator overnight or when there's clouds. So in this case, we actually built a bank of ice inside the refrigerator walls by letting the compressor run extra during the day and freeze this water in the walls into ice, and then it would keep the cold overnight or during extended cloudy periods.
Okay, and let's talk about, you know, some of the space applications of having something like this. I mean, obviously, you're not going to have big batteries or anything like that, so you're saving weight. And, you know, what are some of, like, the real, you mentioned the moon. What are some of the space applications of something like this?
All right, so in space, we need refrigeration for medical samples, for food potentially, and for just cooling the astronauts, cooling the habitat. And that's, like I mentioned, the original place we were looking at the concept was for cooling an entire lunar base. But on a smaller scale, there might be experiments out in any hot environment in space. I talk about the moon in particular because it gets up to about 250 degrees Fahrenheit on the surface of the moon at midday. So that's a very hot environment. And if we would have an experiment out on the surface, there's a very good chance it would need to be cooled in some way. So if we could run it directly from the sunshine that is available, then we could keep the experiment cool.
And I mean, you just said to cool the entire base. So I mean, this is kind of like a technology that could eventually, you know, right now it's a refrigerator, so it's, you know, kind of like maybe a cooler size or something. You're envisioning this could be something that could cool an entire, you know, outpost on something like the moon.
Right. It is very scalable. We can use a larger solar array, larger compressor. So basically, think of an air conditioning system for the larger scale. And we did an experiment here at Johnson Space Center in Building 29 a few years back, where we had a 10-kilowatt solar array outside the building, and we had a 5-ton heat pump unit, similar to what you'd have at your house, that was running directly from the solar panel. So yeah, it can be scaled to a solar refrigerator, can be scaled up to building cooling. The reason that the commercialization has favored the refrigerator is just because of the cost of the solar panels right now. For air conditioning, it would take quite a few solar panels, so there's not quite the market for that yet. But we've seen the solar refrigerator application in off-grid type scenarios is starting to take off commercially.
Okay, so right now you got your design, you have a solar refrigerator. So what are some of the applications you can find here on Earth for something like that? Obviously, you know, places that don't have ready access to power, I'd imagine.
Exactly. So we see this as here in the U.S., it's probably more like recreational cabins, you know, hunting cabins, something like that, where there's no power around for refrigeration. But there's almost 2 billion people in the world that don't have access to electricity. And so that's where the real strong application is, that a lot of countries that don't have an electric grid, but they do have sunshine, can have a solar refrigerator to cool food, for commerce, you know, sell products that need cooling, produce. We see a lot of different applications potential for this. A little bit of work has been done with a milk tank cooler, refrigerated transport, like refrigerated trucks or trains, has been looked into a little bit. But the application that is taking off first is to provide cooling for vaccines in these developing countries. Just last year, the World Health Organization certified our solar refrigerator for use as a vaccine solar refrigerator. And so that has allowed the company that has licensed this technology from NASA to begin marketing those vaccine solar refrigerators.
So, that's, I mean, we're already seeing some real, you know, real useful, real important applications just right here down on the ground. And you, like we said, you're the co-inventor of this, so you just recently, you had just recently gotten a an innovation award or an inventor award from NASA, right? Why don't you tell us a little bit about that real quick?
Okay. Yeah, my co-inventor, David Bergeron, and I received the NASA Commercial Invention of the Year Award for 2011. It's kind of a lengthy process because the patents were actually issued back in 2001. But the company that David actually started, Sundance Refrigeration, just licensed the technology in 2010. And so after that licensing occurred, then they were free to market products. And as I mentioned, the World Health Organization certification made for a more saleable product.
Okay. Well, Mike, I really want to thank you for coming on with me here today. It's a really exciting technology, and it's great to see, you know, something designed initially for space is already getting so much great use down here in the ground. It's already going to be impacting a lot of lives. So, Mike, again, thank you so much for being on. We're really excited to hear about the invention and looking forward to seeing some more applications for it.
Well, thank you very much. I'm glad to be here, and I do hope that the technology that we work on in space can really have a big benefit here on Earth.
All right. Thanks, Mike.
Thank you.